I'm Dr. Kirti, and today I'll be talking about intraoral periapical radiographic techniques. I'll be covering this topic under the following contents, which includes indications of IOPA radiograph and IOPA radiographic techniques, which are bisecting angle technique and paralleling technique. So moving on to the indications, the IOPA radiographs are indicated to assess pulpal infection, periodontal status, trauma to teeth and adjoining structure, to assess root morphology before extraction, during endodontic treatment, to assess unerupted teeth, and to assess periapical cyst and other lesions, and last but not the least, for implant evaluation. So there are two IOPA radiographic techniques. These are bisecting angle technique or short cone technique and paralleling technique or right angle or long cone technique. So the first one is bisecting angle technique, also called as short cone technique due to the short target film distance. It is based on a simple geometrical principle called as Szczesny's rule of isometry, which states that two triangles are equal when they share one common side and have two equal angles. In this, the receptor or film is placed close to the lingual surface of the teeth. The plane of the receptor and long axis of teeth forms an angle where these lines meet. An imaginary lines bisect this angle and the center rays are at right angle to this imaginary bisector, thus forming two triangles with two equal angles and a common side. Film is stabilized either by film holding instrument or patient's finger in this technique, and a size 2 intraoral film is used in this technique. So there are various film holders used in this technique apart from patient's finger. These are Rinn film holder, snap array film holder, stable bite blocks and a hemostat. So the most common one is snap array film holder. Let me tell you the parts of it. It contains a bite block on which a patient bites. It is also used to secure the film in position, an arm and a grip to tighten the holder. After film stabilization comes film placement. In this, the tooth and image receptor should be as close together as possible. They should be parallel to one another. White side of the film always faces the teeth and tube head. The indicator dot is always at the incisal or occlusal level. Anterior films are always placed vertically and posterior films are always placed horizontally. The incisal or occlusal edge of the film must extend 2 to 3 mm beyond the incisal or occlusal surface of the teeth. Always center the film over the tooth of interest. And when positioning the patient's finger to stabilize the film, instruct the patient to gently push the finger against the lingual or palatal surface of the tooth. Now patient positioning. Briefly explain the procedure to the patient. Position the patient upright in the chair and chair level should be at a comfortable working height. Adjust the headrest to support the patient's head. Make sure that the occlusal plane is parallel to the floor and the mid-sagittal plane is perpendicular to the floor. Place and secure the lead apron and thyroid collar over the patient and remove all the objects such as eyeglasses, dentures, retainers and chewing gums. Now comes the PID angulation, which is position indicating device angulations. It includes horizontal and vertical angulation. For an accurate horizontal angulation, the central ray of the X-ray beam must be directed through the contact areas between the teeth. And for the vertical angulation, the central ray should be directed perpendicular to the imaginary bisector. So these are the recommended vertical angulation for maxillary and mandibular teeth. The positive vertical angulation is the angulation above the occlusal surface and the negative vertical angulation is the angulation below the occlusal plane. So to summarize, firstly a film is placed either by using film holder or a finger. Then comes film orientation. The white surface should be at the towards the teeth or tube head and occlusal dot at the occlusal level. Then patient positioning, the occlusal plane should be parallel to the floor and mid-sagittal plane should be perpendicular to the floor. In tube head positioning, horizontal and vertical angulation should be taken care of and at last exposure is made. Now about the advantages and disadvantages. Advantages are, it is a comfortable, simple and quick technique. It can be used even without a film holder when the anatomy of the patient doesn't precludes the use of film holding device. If all the angulations are assessed correctly, the image of the tooth will be as same length as the tooth and it's adequate for diagnostic purpose. And in this, there is a decreased exposure time due to the short PID. Disadvantages are patient's hand is in the path of primary beam, thus it causes unnecessary exposure. Due to incorrect horizontal tube angulation, there is overlapping of the crowns and roots, and incorrect vertical tube angulation, there can be foreshortening or elongation of image. There are also image distortions in the form of magnification and film building, and chances of cone cutting are also high in this technique. The shadow of the zygomatic buttress overlies the root of upper molars, and it is not possible to obtain reproducible views in this technique. So now moving on to the next technique, which is paling technique. This technique shows the parallelism between the long axis of the tooth and the receptor. The central ray is directed perpendicular to each. A long target film distance is used in this technique to ensure parallelism. So that's why it is called as long cone technique. So the film holders used in this technique are Rin XCP film holder and a precision film holder. The most common one is Rin XCP film holder. So let me tell you the parts of it. It contains a film holder or film support to support the film, a bite block on which a patient bites, a metal arm, and a locator ring. Now comes film placement. The film must be positioned parallel to the long axis of the tooth. Always place the film away from the teeth and towards the middle of the oral cavity. Always center the film over the tooth to be examined. As I've told earlier, the white surface is always towards the teeth and tube head, and indicated dot is always towards the incisal or occlusal level. Always lead with the apical end of the film and rotate the film holder so that the teeth under investigation touches the bite block. Ask the patient to slowly close on the bite block. Always make sure that the bite block is stabilized by the teeth, not by the lips. Now about PID angulations. Afterwards, a locator ring is moved down the indicator rod until it is in contact with the patient's face. To ensure a correct horizontal angulation, the central ray of the X-ray beam must be directed through the contact areas between the teeth, and for the vertical angulation, it should be directed perpendicular to the film and the long axis of the tooth. Afterwards, the X-ray beam must be centered on the film to ensure that all the areas of film are exposed, and hence, finally, exposure is made. So about the advantages and disadvantages. Advantages are, in this technique, geometrically accurate images with little magnification comes. Shadow of the zygomatic buttress appears above the apices of molars. Crowns of teeth are well depicted, so hence it is good for detection of proximal caries. There is no foreshortening, elongation and cone cutting, and reproducible images are produced. Disadvantages are, positioning of the films can sometimes be uncomfortable for posterior teeth, hence causing gagging. Positioning of the holders within the mouth can be difficult for inexperienced operators. Anatomy of the mouth sometimes make this technique impossible, for example, in case of shallow or flat palate or in case of third molars. Sometimes apices of the teeth are very close to the edge of the film and the peripical area is not well depicted. And there is obviously increase in exposure time due to increased target and patient distance. And holders are used, hence they need to be autoclaved and disposed. So which do you think is the technique of choice for us? On the right side are the IOPA images taken by bisecting angle technique, and on the left side are the IOPA images taken by paling technique. So the answer is right in front of you. As due to the accurate imaging and reproducibility, paling technique should be the technique of choice. However, if all the angulations are assessed correctly, bisecting angle technique is not bad also. So these are the references and suggested reading. Thank you. If you liked my video, please subscribe to my channel All About Teeth and press the bell icon to get the latest notifications.